Let's play Ghostbusters. This is one of the modern tables I was talking about from 2016. Let's refreshments here. This boots up. One of my favorite tables I've just learned how to play decently. I was going to stay here too. Before I forget, of course, I'll always ask this. How are people doing? Do we have any wins we want to talk about? Did something good happen to you? Because Uncle Gutty's stream is all about basically positivity. So I'd like to ask people, if you got a win, drop it in so we can celebrate. Because it's really easy to lose sight of all the positive things that's going on in the world, especially with us. Sometimes we get beat down a lot too. So for me, my win is my wife, TXS Mom, will be getting a promotion soon. So I'm very happy for that, very proud of her. She worked really hard on that, and I'm going to celebrate that. That's my win, because when Shree succeeds, I get really excited about that. I'm going to try and do a quick prediction here. All right, let's do this one here. Will I capture 60 ghosts? Yes. So in this game, as you do things, you capture ghosts in the ghost trap, basically, on the game. I'll start right now. If you get 100 ghosts, you get basically to super super jackpot mode. It goes 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. I'm gonna put up right now. You can wager some channel points if you want. Will I capture 60 ghosts this game? That's the question. Gee, Switzer, I got a new dryer tonight because my one died on Sunday. Oh. So my question is, what'd she die of? Ha! Sorry, no. Just kidding. Dumb question, Switz. How old was your dryer? Because I'm finding basically a lot of the new appliances don't last as long. I know it's gonna sound dumb being an old guy, but the Kenmore appliances from the 70s and 80s would last for like 20, 30 years. Guaranteed, no problem. Nowadays, if you get 10 years under a fridge, I'm surprised. The tide of streaks, under roof streaks. Ooh. Just gotta get a, oh, we got our prediction in. Someone knows me all too well. Here we go. Shoot for 60 ghosts or more. Maybe not. Yeah, 20 years old is good, though. Like you said, you can't say that you didn't get your money's out of it. my mom's fridge and stove finally quit after like 30 or 40 years. So she had to go get a new fridge. She was very disappointed that the color Harvest Gold is no longer an option. So I said, I absolutely adore this game. This game is fun to play in real life as well. One of my first jobs was Sears Outlet. The older machines were simple to fix. You know what, Pem? That is like crazy true, because when the old dryer fix, I looked up on YouTube on how to like give it a repair. It wasn't hard. Nowadays, I wouldn't dare try and take these things apart. There's so many bells and whistles on them, I'd be afraid of getting electrocuted. Let's try and hit some loops here. I haven't hit 20 ghosts yet, so someone might be in for a treat. Oh my gosh. So whoever wagered that prediction might be making some money here, because unless I have a fantastic game and score 60 ghosts on this one. I'll try that. This table is also notoriously hard. It will gut your ball. It will gut your ball like that very easily. I'm not sure if that's done intentionally, but I do remember playing the Game of Thrones in real life, the table. That was a terrible game. It's actually the first salesperson to be on the best of the best list. Now that Stir wasn't around for a couple years. Hey, that's a win. What's my prediction? Where's my prediction? Take your chow points. Take your chow points, you. Thank you, D-Terps. Thank you very much. What's around with yours at 19? That's a win, Pam. That's a big win. Thank you all for watching. Playing the prediction. Sorry I disappointed you. Like I said, my first job, one of my first jobs I liked was I was working in consumer distributing. Consumer distributing was a Canadian version of Amazon. So basically, they had a warehouse with a kind of a nice fancy showroom up front with catalogs. You would go in, look through the catalog, write out what you want on a piece of paper, and take it to the cash. And some guy in the back would run around and get your stuff and bring it to you. I was a guy bringing your stuff to you. Thank you very much for the bits. That's so sweet, everybody. It's so awesome. Like I said, everything on this channel, I don't need your subs. I don't need your bits. I need your donations. All I would like to, if you tell people about the channel or do a good deed for someone, that's all I want. Like I said, I want people to come here, relax, and have fun. But anything I make the channel goes to an amazing rescue called Birchhaven Rescue and Rehabilitation. They are a giant breed, especially in dog rescue, specializing in St. Bernards, Great Danes. But in reality, they'll turn no dog away in need. They've been in business for over 20 years, transitioning soon to a haven program, where basically they're going to be going out and saving dogs that cannot be adopted either for physical or psychological reasons and taking care of them. People are the salt of the earth, hoping to see them soon. Thank you very much. I hope next stream we'll have a grand total for last year of what we all managed to raise for them. And I much appreciate it. Anyways, back to the game. And also, because we were distributing, I was a warehouse runner. My job was to be in the back when an order came through. And I would run and go get your order for you. So running through the warehouse, trying not to break my neck. Houston, thank you very much. Much appreciate it. You're so kind. That was my favorite jobs. I had a lot of fun. It was fun getting the light items. There we go. Nice save. But the heavy items like weight sets and TVs, like the old tube TVs, that sucked. So you try not to be the last guy to the ticket machine. So right now I've got a mode going on called Terror Dogs, where I've got to try to do as many loops as possible to get extra points. Trying to control the ball, that's half the battle. Not good at all. I've got Discord up now too, people. If you want to stop in and see what I'm doing on a day-to-day basis, hear more about my podcast, or just have good fun, that's the place to be. I finally caved in and actually started a Discord for once. Every week I post a question of the, can't find the ball. There we go. Ball search. Is the ball stuck? Oh, it's going to actually go through and do a ball search, actually. So, normally when a ball gets stuck, the machine will wait and do a search. If not, it'll throw another ball into play here. This will be interesting. So it's looking for the ball like a real machine would. It should actually fish me another ball here. Anyways, as I was saying, though, I have a Discord now. One of the fun things I do is I post question of the week. I know, right, Switz? Let's see if it pops up another ball here. So if you want to get Discord, have fun. This question of the week goes till Sunday. I asked, basically, what is the most beautiful place you've been to? My pick was Oahu, Hawaii. I've had, someone said Niagara Falls. I had a lot of good picks in there. The place to be was... Yes, Mr. Switz. Let's see if it goes one more time here. Pinball, Missman, please wait. Okay, I'm waiting a little bit. You! So it actually took my ball on me. That's horrible. As Switz was saying, this Thursday, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, we are doing another Old Man Theater, where G Switzer and I will be running down a topic. And this week's topic, or this show's topic, will be Star Trek the original series. We'll be telling you basically what it was about, a few bits of trivia, how much the cast hated each other, and how much of a dick William Shatner really was on that show. Should be a good time. We'll also be writing down basically our five favorite episodes and five not so favorite episodes. And sneak peek, one of my not favorite episodes was Spock's brain. Don't ask, you know, don't even bother seeing it. Anyways, that's Old Man Theater, Thursday night, 9 p.m. Be there if you want to see it. It'll be up on YouTube later.